Testing your mobile app on an actual device can be a frustrating experience. Getting your hands on a test device, installing the app, trying to execute all sorts of test cases. Bitrise can help you automate this part of the development process too. And all you need are some tests and your device testing steps. We have two steps dedicated to running tests on devices: virtual device testing on Android and device testing on iOS. Both use Google's Firebase service to run your test, but you do not need your own Firebase account to use them. We will take care of that. However, be aware that only one of these steps can be used in a single build. If you try to use more than one, any device testing step after the first will return an error. So let's talk about how to use the steps. In this video, we will go through setting up virtual device testing on Android. This step runs your tests on emulated Android devices in the Firebase Test Lab. Let's set one up. First, you need an APK. You can also build an AAB file, but for this video, we will go with an APK. There are several steps that can build you one, but for this tutorial, we will do it with an Android build. We will go to the workflow editor and edit your workflow. Set its variant input to debug. This ensures you will get a testing APK. Its path will be stored in an environment variable called Bitrise APK path. Now add the virtual device testing for Android step to your workflow after the Android build step. Otherwise, it won't have access to the APK. There's no need to modify the app path input. By default, it should point to the file exported by the Android build step. In the test devices input, choose the device or devices you want. If you click on the input, you can see the available devices and their possible configurations. You can have one device configuration per line like this. Choose a test type in the test types input. Explaining the robo, instrumentation and game loop types is not the scope of this video. You can read more about them in Firebase's documentation. For now, we will select robo. Robo test analyzes the structure of your app's UI and explores it methodically, automatically stimulating user activities. Go to the RoboTest input group and find the RoboDirectives input. Here you can set the required user input directives. For example, stimulate a login by adding text to the username and password fields and clicking the login button. In the example, our app has a username element called UsernameText, a password element called PasswordTxt, a login button element called LoginBTN. We will add three directives, each on its own line with the parameters separated by comma. We tell the RoboTest to add the text username to username text and to simulate a single click on the login BTN. Our virtual device testing step is ready to go with some RoboTesting. If you would like some tips for instrumentation tests, check out our documentation. Here's the link. Now we just need to deploy to bitrise.io step to export our test results. With this step, the results will be available in the test report add-in. In the add-in, you can view, analyze, and download your results all in an intuitive interface. To learn more about it, check out our test reports video.